Today we are going to cover the following topics. In this video, we will study about Ethernet cables, coaxial cable, optical fiber cable, Bluetooth, then intranet technology and Wi-Fi. So these, all the topics which we are going to cover today, all these are networking media, means the device through which your network will work, your network will transmit data. And this networking media, it can be either wired or wireless, means the media which uses wires, they are called as wired networking technology, and which doesn't use any wire, they are wireless networking technologies. So first we are going to study some wired networking technologies. In this, the first one is Ethernet cables. Here in this picture you can see this is an Ethernet cable. Most of you must have seen in your home also, these cables are used in devices. And here we have some features of these Ethernet cables. One by one we will deal them. An Ethernet cable is one of the most popular form of network cable used in wired networks. So this is very popular. This cable resembles a phone cable but is larger than the phone cable and has 8 wires. So here is one difference between the phone cable which we have in our phones and this Ethernet cable. It is that it is slightly larger. As you can see, this is slightly larger, and one characteristic of this is that it has 8 wires. It connects various devices such as PCs, routers, switches within LAN. So this device is used in LAN. They have less power consumption. This device, they consume less power. It requires an Ethernet adapter card. This device is required to establish networking. Then two types of Ethernet cables are. There are two types of Ethernet cable. One is crossover cable and the other one is straight through cable. Now this crossover cable, this is designed for connecting two computers without a hub or router. Now what is hub and router? Hub, you know what is hub, and router you will see in you will study about this in the next class. So this crossover cable, these are designed for connecting two computers without hub or router. You know that hub is used to connect two or more computers in a network. So these are not required when there is crossover cable. And then the second one is straight through cable, which is used to connect a computer to router or switch. And this device, this is used to connect to router or switch. These devices also we will study in the next video. So this is all about Ethernet cables. The next is your coaxial cable. This is also, you must have seen this. This is a picture of coaxial cable. So here are some features of coaxial cable. Coaxial cable is used in the transmission of video communications and audio. So these are very useful in communicating data. Then it is used by the cable television industry to connect TVs to a cable. So this, you must have seen these cables in your, if you have any cable connection at home, then you must have seen this cable. Then this can also be used in networks, not only for cable industry, but it is also useful in networks also. And here are some features of this coaxial cable. This consists of copper wire surrounded by insulation and then a shield of braided wire. Here you can see that this is an insulation, and inside this there is some connected wires. These are braided wires. It is relatively inexpensive and can transmit data at higher rate. One very important feature of this is that this is inexpensive and the cost is very less. And this, but price is less, but this can transmit data at higher rate. It provides better immunity against electromagnetic disturbances. Now you must you should know that whenever any signal travels across network, then many disturbances can be faced by those data. So here it is given one advantage of this coaxial cable is that it provides immunity against this electromagnetic disturbances, means it will protect your data from any disturbance when it is flowing across a network. Its disadvantage is high installation cost and maintenance cost. So this one disadvantage of this kind of cable is that this requires high installation cost and maintenance cost is also high. Then there are two types of coaxial cable. It's a the first one is baseband coaxial cable. This supports quick transmission of a single signal at a time. It is mainly used for LAN. So here you have baseband and broadband coaxial cable. Major difference is that baseband coaxial cable will allow only a single signal at a time, whereas your broadband coaxial cable, this transmits multiple signal at the same time and is used for long distances. So this is one major difference between a baseband coaxial cable and broadband coaxial cable. The next is your optical fiber cable. Here the picture is of that of optical fiber cable. Now what are its features? It is a popular technology that has a larger capacity to transfer data at a very high speed. So this is one very important feature of optical fiber cable, that it transmits data at very high speed. Then a fiber optic cable consists of a central glass core containing a bundle of glass threads. Here you can see these are the bundle of glass threads surrounded by several layers of protective materials. And this is cut to show you the wires, but these are shielded by protective materials. The glass threads are capable of transmitting data converted into light signals at extremely high speed. Now in this optical fiber cable, the data is converted into light signals, and that is why it can travel in very high speed, because you know that the speed of light is very high. Then it is highly resistant to signal interference. Now signal interference means the disturbance which is faced by any data when it flows across a network. So this provides high resistance, means it will protect the signal from any disturbance and provides better data transmission by providing high bandwidth. Data will travel at a very high speed, so that is why this provides a high bandwidth. One disadvantage is that its maintenance cost is high. So these are some of the features of optical fiber cable. Next we will study about some wireless networking technologies. Means this technology, they doesn't use any wire. So if they are not using wire, so this technology will be used in lower distance. In less distance, these can be used. Like the first one is your Bluetooth. You must have seen Bluetooth facility available in your mobile phones. Now what are these? This uses low power radio waves to connect electronic devices. Here are some of the features of this Bluetooth device. Then allows users to talk and share information. You know that if you switch on the Bluetooth into more devices, then among those devices you can share information. Then mainly used for PAN. PAN means personal area network. I told you that PAN is the network which is established in your home and which covers a very small region. So but up to 240 meters only. This is a very small range within which this Bluetooth can work. And this doesn't use any cable and adapter, because this is a wireless networking technology. The next one is infrared technology. This you must have seen in remote control. The remote control, when you press any button with remote control to operate your television or any device, then they use this infrared signals to communicate. Now here are some features of infrared technology. It is a short range communication technology that covers approximately 5 meters. So beyond this you will not be able to do communication. Then it emits infrared waves for communication. So infrared waves are used for communication. Signals cannot penetrate through walls or obstructions, and this work in straight line. So if there is a wall in between two or more rooms, then you will not be able to give any command through your infrared device. So this provides an obstruction. Example of this is remote control. Then the next one is Wi-Fi. This Wi-Fi, many of you must be having your Wi-Fi connection at home. So this stands for wireless fidelity. Wi-Fi stands for wireless fidelity. This creates wireless local area network that uses radio waves to send information. So here we saw that it uses infrared waves, and this uses radio waves to send information. Next point is that a secure, reliable and fast wireless connection is established by this technology. So this kind of technology, this is very reliable and safe, and it's very fast also. But one adapter is required. If you are having Wi-Fi connection, then adapter is required. Then multiple devices can be connected through Wi-Fi. It is relatively inexpensive. And one disadvantage is that it has high power consumption. So these are some of the features of wireless networking technology.